All right, Mr. Roderick, where are we at now?
We're at Ripley's, believe it or not.
Stop two on our computer science tour. Here we go.
My name's Nathan Barnes. I'm one of the IT supervisors here at Ripley's. We've got 13 attractions, including the aquarium, the Believe It or Not, and a bunch of other ones. Our job is to make sure that these guys have all the tools to do their jobs every day. So everything from point of sale systems to the interactive technology that our customers get to interact with going through our attractions. With something called a brain sign unit. Those things are programmed to work together. There's also sensors that see when people walk up. So those have to be programmed, coordinated together, make sure they're powered on every day at the right times, powered off at the right times. Ripley's is very big on ecology, so we're trying to prevent as much power waste as possible. So we use automated systems like this to prevent as much power waste as possible. So we utilize things like clear TV screens. So we can put images on the screen and put artifacts behind it and give people information about what's behind it with a screen that allows us to program whatever we want. So times like this where it's opaque because it's highlighting one specific thing, basically it's just not putting anything on that part of the screen. So we use this kind of technology all over our Believe It or Not.
Okay, just hold her and put your hand on there.
So this is our dance interactive. There's a camera on every single TV and a computer that runs every one of the TVs. And if you look, it's got a different effect across all five TVs. So
all
people will walk through the room and it's crazy cool effect on every TV. But that projector that's up there is what's called an ultra short throw projector. Our room is only about 6 feet wide, so we needed to be able to cover this entire screen with projectors. So it's also a laser projector. You never change the bulb in it. They're very, very bright. They're very, very colorful. So we use stuff like that. These guys came to us and said, we need a better solution to this. And this is what we found to do it. But they use these in schools a lot because you can walk right up to the wall and you won't be in this, so you won't block any of the picture. So they're very, very good in classrooms. The height of the sand is very, very important. It's also using an Xbox Kinect sensor that's constantly looking at the height of the sand, and you can come in and make the water move, so we can tell it that the water is allowed to flow down that way. There's things in the sand that are buried, and if you dig far enough, you can find them. Very, very interesting to show kids this kind of technology. Really fun. Touchscreen. For all intents and purposes, it's a massive iPad. This is something that we use for ecology in the area. You can actually touch the screen and pick an animal or a plant, and it'll tell you information about it. So where it's located, facts about it. Talking about grainy slime mold. So Ripley's, we like things that are interesting and weird. So things like slime mold or a plant that looks like a heart. We've got huge amounts of flora and fauna in this area that are unique to this area. And this is just something that we use to try to highlight those things and help with the ecology efforts in this area. And we partnered kind of with the Smoky Mountain National Park to get all this information. So very, very cool interactive. Very high frame per second. So, I forget, where was this? The Red Sox 2004 World Series. You can go from when the game was still going on to right after they won and see how many people ended up in the middle of the street. But we love these guys because gives you a different perspective on the world. You get to see things super fast.